Gumboat Man, and you should subscribe to ZRB. Also, drop a like on the video right now.
Yo, boys, how's it going? Hope you guys had a great Thanksgiving. A lot of you guys been telling me you wanted a how do I make a custom tracers video, and a lot of you been asking me how to make custom tracers or custom Bloodfx. Well, today I'm going to show you. A lot of you know that I made one of those first tracer packs with all the colors in them. I'm going to show a picture up here. Got hella downloads. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to make tracers, how to make custom Bloodfx, and how to combine them and use the RPF file format in OpenIV to add it to your mods folder. As always, timestamps will be in the video's time bar or in the description. It's going to be a long one. Let's go. Alright, so let's get right into it. First thing we're going to be doing is I'm going to be going over the requirements with you guys and what software you're going to need before you start doing this. So I made a pack that you guys can download on my Discord right in the downloads channel. You guys are going to be able to download this pack. I have a picture I made in Photoshop telling you guys everything you need. You need Photoshop 2020 or less. I don't think 2021 works with it, so I want to use that. There's a plugin you need to install. I'm going to show you guys how to do that. You're going to need OpenIV. Most of you probably have that. And Texture Toolkit, which is part of the pack. GIMP is also an alternative if you can't find a working Photoshop. I have the Photoshop and the plugin in here. So once you download Photoshop, just run the plugin and install it with it. All you got to do is just go like this. I already have it, but once you go here, you hit next, agree. And then you browse your Photoshop to wherever you put it. My Photoshop is right here, but that's what you're going to be doing. I'm going to hit no because I don't need it. The RPF file is going to be right here that you're going to use. Texture toolkit is going to be here. And two Bloodfx files is going to be here for depending on what you want to do. The pack is going to be in the description. Let's get right into initial setup and extracting the and working on it. Alright, so first thing you want to do, I'm going to be teaching you guys my workflow and how I do this. So first thing you're going to want to do, I just make a folder called Bloodfx dev. And I'm going to make a folder in here that says pics, because we're going to be extracting the pic and the core.ypt. So we're going to open OpenIV. We're going to need OpenIV, GRTF5 Windows. We're going to open our pack folder. We're going to get the RPF file. Let me exit out of this one. All right, and then you just want to close all three. So it's very little like this. You drag the RPF to the bottom of all these three into the white area. There you go. Now we go into all the way through the folders until we hit core.ypt. Now we're just going to, we can exit out of that other folder and we can open this one. Now we can just go into core.ypt and drag it out just like that, and we're good. Now you can just minimize OpenIV for now. All right, now you're going to want to open Texture Toolkit. So we're just going to open our old pack folder and open Texture Toolkit.exe. Exit out of that. Now you want to hit file, load, and now you're going to locate the location of this. The easiest way is just to hit the search bar at the top, hit Control C to copy, go to your left window, hit Control V to paste it, hit enter, and it's like core.ypt. Now essentially all you're going to do is just edit the texture. So we're going to get all the things we need. I'm going to get the Bloodfx and the tracer files to put them into one pack. So I'm going to export, select ptfx underscore bullet underscore tracer. I'm going to hit export this into pix. So hit save. Now I'm going to keep going down to PTFX underscore muzzle underscore 01. I'm also going to be doing custom muzzle flash colors with this. You don't have to get these if you don't want to, but I would suggest it. Going to want to hit save. I changed these all for you, so it's easy to select it. PTFX underscore muzzle underscore core underscore 02. I'm going to export that one. Save. Scroll down. Go down to PTFX underscore muzzle underscore 02. Select it. Export. Save. Now you can go down a little bit more because we're done with the muzzle and the tracer. Keep going down until you see PTFX underscore clone underscore muzzle underscore core. You're going to want to export this one. Hit save. Export symbols. Two up above it. Hit save. You can also do muzzle, but I left it empty because I don't really use it and there's no point. I noticed that there's no change in effect with it, so I'm going to just leave it. You can actually just keep this minimized for now. And I'm going to go into Photoshop. Load these into Photoshop and start editing my pictures. Let's get right into it. All right, so once you guys open Photoshop, if you installed the plugin correctly, we're going to open our folder right here and we're going to get pics. If you installed the plugin correctly, we're just going to drag this right onto Photoshop, and another window should pop up saying NVIDIA DDS read properties. Don't check in, don't check off anything, just hit okay. We're going to do that for the rest of our pictures. I'm just selecting them by hitting control. We're just going to drag them up the top near the bars. I'm just going to keep hitting okay. So I select them all. Now I already kind of changed this to help you guys. I made it black so it's easier to select the wand tool. I'm going to go through this. I'm kind of going to fast forward it. But all I'm going to do is I'm going to select the wand tool on the outside of these. So select the outside. Then you're going to want to hit select inverse to invert it. Then you want to get your paint tool. And I'm going to be making a, I'm going to make a red one. Bright colors are usually easier to work with the tracers. I'm going to make the brush tool very big. We're just going to paint over this. Now you're going to notice this gets painted in the bottom right. You could just get a smaller eraser tool. Get rid of that. And there you go. You have it colored. Now you want to do this for each thing. So I'm going to just eraser tool this real quick. I'm going to go quicker now because you guys can just rewatch before.
Do the same thing for each. Like that, select, inverse, paint it. There we go, I'm gonna make a brush smaller. Okay, so for these, I'm gonna do the tracer real quick. I'll tell you guys how to do the other one. You select the tracer, not the. Alright, we'll just do the edges. If you wanna select multiple, like if it's only one box like this, you can hit shift, select multiple.
You wanna hit select, inverse. Make this right. Alright, so for these, I just made this so it's easier, but I'm gonna do an image. So I'm gonna just do, I'm gonna go to Google, I'm gonna pull up a image of a Sharing gun. And we're just gonna do that. Pretty easy to do, just find a basic PNG for it. And I'm gonna show you guys how to do this. I'm just gonna save it because it's easier, so I don't feel like cutting it out. Put it in our downloads, drag it on. It's already cut out for us. All right, so now you want to kind of follow this area. You don't want to overlap because you don't want one being bigger and going over half the image over the other because it'll cause issues. There's some, you want them to be symmetrical. So like this kind of, we'll do this, and then if you could select the layer and hit Control J and just move it directly across like this for easiness. Pick the bottom layer and then you're just going to use your eraser tool to get rid of the background. There you go, that's how you do it. Now I'm gonna just copy this Control C and paste it onto the next layer. Control T if you want to resize it like what I'm doing right now. And I'm gonna make these fairly kind of small, and Control J, Control J, Control J. I'm gonna readjust them in a second, like this. All right, I'm gonna switch the rotation on them a little bit. We'll make the rotation a little bit more randomized. Control T and just go in the edge in the corners and just rotate it. That's what I'm doing right now. All right, there we go. And then I'm gonna just get the eraser tool, go down to the very last layer at the bottom, MIP zero. Then just erase the background. And there you guys go. We have all our images edited. They're done. So now you want to hit Control Shift S to save as. You need to save as. You can't export. And then under save is type right here. Make sure you select DDS-NVIDIA Texture Tools Exporter. Make sure it's the same name. Hit save. Hit replace. And now you're going to select your next tab once it's done saving. Well, actually, another window is going to pop up. Make sure at the format, it's BC3. You can do BC7 too, but BC3 will be able to view it just to make sure you did it correctly. You want to hit save. There we go. So we're just going to do this for each of these. Hit save. Window's going to pop up. Hit save again. Control Shift S. Hit save. Hit yes. Hit save again. Again, once you hit Control Shift S, make sure, see, it changed for me. We're going to go to DDS and do it again. Sometimes it changes to PSD, so you got to redo it. And select the bottom to DDS like you just did again. Save, DDS, save, yes, save. Now I'm actually going to close out of my Photoshop because if a view to my pics, I can see that I edited them. I'm not going to save any of these. I don't really need it. I can always redo it if I mess up. Boom, you have all your pics. All right, so now I'm going to teach you guys how to import these into your texture toolkit. And add it to the RPF, and I'll be teaching you guys the RPF format and how to rename it to your own name. So with Texture Toolkit, it's going to be the same thing. You're just going to... That was my Discord, not yours. We're going to go into Texture Toolkit. You're just going to hit Edit, Import. And since these are all named correctly, you don't need to do anything. You can actually just hit select one, hit Shift, select that, hit Open. And there you guys go. Just make sure one of them, or make sure two images that they're changed. You can go down to the bottom where the clone ones are. You can just make sure they're changed. You want to hit file save. I usually say the program will freeze for a sec, so you know it's working. I usually save twice. Now you can actually exit out of both of these. And so what you just did, you just changed the YPT file. You can check by the date if it matches with yours right now and the time. That means you've recently edited it. Now we're going to go back into our open IV that we had open. You can open that again and just drag back in the RPF, same thing. And now, as you can see, if you open the double click on the core YPT, we zoom out a little bit, hit view embedded textures, we can see this is the old one. These are old PTFX ones. And we're going to just replace these with our current core YPT that we just edited. Boom. You're going to want to just drag it in. Make sure you have edit mode on. That's what you're going to need to just drag and drop it like that. And now you can open it. And now you can hit view embedded textures. And you can see that it's changed to red. We changed all of them to red. I actually forgot to change this one. But it's the same process. If you need help, just DM me on Discord. You're just going to want to export this out of your... this one, PTFX Gen Ribbon Test, edited on Photoshop and just imported back in. Same thing. I forgot to edit that one. That one's going to be the little twirly thing around your body. I'll show you guys. Once it's in, there you guys go. Now I'm going to be teaching you guys the RPF file format at the end of the video, actually. So I'll teach you guys. Just skip over to the end. And next, we're going to be testing this in game to see how it works. So since you have that RPF file done and you already edited it, you can just copy this, go to your FiveM application data. If you don't know how to, just hit your Windows key and R, type in percent local app data percent. You're going to want to scroll down to FiveM application data, mods, get rid of if you have a particles or RPF or anything that'll interfere, and just paste yours in. And now we're going to go and give them a test it. All right guys, we're here in game to test. I actually did end up editing the PTFX ribbon file, and I change it to red just so it's by around their bodies. And this is what it looks like. So as you can see, the muzzle and the tracer are working. And there's a little spinning thing around their bodies. Test out the headshot. Boom, it's working. It's a little bit messed up, but I think it's just because I messed up on the quality of the image. It's not that good of a picture. I think I did a little bit too big. But as you guys can see, it works. The body shot works and everything. Got yourself a very simple, nice and clean Bloodfx. Ghost mode all the way over there. Ah, never mind, I'm whiffing. We'll kill some all the way over here. Boom, it works even from a distance. And yeah, you guys got it. And yeah, now we're going to be reviewing the Bloodfx .dat files. Let's get right into it. Alright, I'm going to be showing you guys the RPF file format and how to rename it and change it to yours. So actually, I'm going to exit out of this real quick. Or I'm not, I don't need to. Once you open IV, you're just going to drag it into the white area like usual. I'm quickly going to exit out of it. I'm going to close the archive. And you can rename this whatever you want. So I'm just going to call it D0B. Sharingan. Bloodfx. Plus. Tracer. It doesn't matter about the name. The name doesn't matter. You can drag that into the white area. Alright, so now you're going to click on your assembly.xml. Right click it. Hit edit. Alright. Now, as you guys can see, there's a bunch of random useless stuff. You guys might not know what this stuff is, but the name, you can change this. So, Zorbi's Showering. I put rename so you guys know what to rename, but there's a couple extra stuff you can rename in here. Zorbi's Showering Gun, Tracer, Plus, Bloodfx, Pack, 2021. Alright, and then display name, you can change this to your name. I already did. Action link, I'm gonna change this to my YouTube channel instead. Just a link. This doesn't really do anything, to be honest. Or it might, but I'm not sure what it does. Might do something in game. I'm just gonna change my YouTube link. Web is just a website function, I think, with XML. So I'm gonna just put that to Discord. None of this really matters. You can just change this to your name, but if you leave it empty, your game will crash. So footer link, I'm just going to put that to my name, put this to my name. C data, I made by Zerby, known as Zerby. Display name Zerby, footer link Zerby, footer link title Zerby. C data, I just left that empty. Large description, license, I just left that empty. Content by Zerby Pepis, there usually says content by Rockstar, but that's just licensing. I don't think it legally matters. They're not going to sue you because you changed that, hopefully. go down. Now, this is what matters right here. So, your... it's not going to work if you don't change this. If you leave it as rename, it will work because of the way I set this up. But if you want to change this so no one can steal your credit, this is how you add the sources. This is going to, whenever you run 5M, it's going to add this mod pack to your story mode through update X4 DLC packs, rename this, and to DLC RPF. So add source, you're going to call this whatever you want. I call mine just Zerby Bloodfx, like this. and I copy the name and just paste it onto the rename part right here, and I save it. Now, if you go into content, you need to rename this one to the exact same thing or it won't work. If you go to setup two shouldn't really matter. I usually always add a comment too, like with a left closing arrow like this, exclamation point dash dash, we'll make it a comment, and then go discord.gg/yorby/closing arrow like this. This will leave a comment so it won't read it. It'll just go past it. Rename. I don't know what this stuff does, but I saw it in someone else's RPF mods folder, so I left it. And I'm just gonna rename that to the exact same thing. That's what I usually do. And I also put the comment. I'm not gonna put the comment. Actually, I'll just do it quickly. So arrow exclamation point dash dash space discord.gg/yorby/arrow. Boom. Now we're gonna change both of the renames. Here we go. Go into x64. You need to rename this one too. There you go. That's your core. That's how the new RPF file format works. In all my packs, I usually add a bloodfx.dat in here, but it's very buggy. I added it into here, but it's very buggy for some reason. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. So I just usually have like clients or people I give my packs to added in themselves to common datafx. And yeah, that's pretty much how the RPF file format works. It touch guys everything. And yeah, if you want to see advanced examples, I'm going to leave some pictures at the end of what more files you need to replace with the bloodfx.dat to use the advanced one. And yeah, see you guys in the next video. When I get unbanned in 5M in 30 days, yeah, my ban's like 36 days, I'm going to start uploading twice a week. I'm going to start bringing 1 week uploads back, hopefully, and when I get unbanned, I'll be uploading twice a week, and we're going to go crazy. And yeah, see you guys. See you guys in the next video. Peace.